Finally, the connection. Tonight, a few lives remembered from the civil rights era. They would have been in their early 60s now, grandmothers perhaps, maybe nearing the end of their careers or enjoying retirement. Instead, Denise McNair, Carol Robertson, Addie Mae Collins, and Cynthia Wesley were killed 50 years ago today in one of the worst acts of violence during the civil rights movement. They died on a Sunday morning when the church they attended, the 16th Street Baptist Church in Birmingham, Alabama, was bombed. This recollection is from a new documentary called Preserving Justice.
My teacher, Miss Wesley, her daughter was one of the ones who was killed in that church bombing, Cynthia Wesley. And I can remember seeing her sitting on the stoop outside the emergency room crying.
This man survived those very dangerous times, even though he was a civil rights attorney who worked with Rosa Parks and Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. His name was Demetrius Newton, and he was interviewed for the same documentary.
I saw two white police officers manhandle a young black girl that I knew, and I think it was the catalyst that perhaps led me to choose a career.
Later, Newton became the first African-American to serve as president pro tem of the Alabama House. He died at the age of 85 earlier this week. 50 years after that church bombing, he was fondly remembered by both black and white Alabamans. And those four girls who lived such terribly short lives were remembered throughout Birmingham. This morning, bells tolled at 10:22, the time the bomb exploded, and the Sunday school lesson that was interrupted that day was read from start to finish.